Hi guys, so I'm back today with a project share, and it's sideways because I can't actually get the entire thing when I have it this way. It cuts off a little bit, but I guess that's not too bad. So this is a project that I did for swap that I joined over at Creating the Crafty Life. And this is actually the loaded envelope, as you can see, and it is their Graphic 45 loaded envelope. So you could use any collection that you wanted. You had to make a loaded envelope using any collection. So it could be any style or anything like that. So my partner is Kerry, and I will try and remember to link her YouTube down below. And I used the Graphic 45 Gilded Lilly. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. So, excuse me, I'm so sorry, guys. So I made a few things. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the clothespins off. So I made some clothespin rosettes, and, so I used the Graphic 45 paper. I have that rosette file. Actually, I have a couple of them, but I have a rosette file that I used, and then I used this Martha Stewart punch, the lacy doily lace punch or something like that, on the edges. I used some flower, I don't even know what this is, but I used some pieces, they're kind of doily pieces from my stash. And then there is also all these flowers are from Wild Orchid Crafts. And I used several different, I used white and then several different colors of pink. And then I covered both sides with the pattern paper. And I was having trouble keeping them, keeping the clothespins together. I don't know, these seemed to be kind of loose. So I actually added a little bit of the art glitter glue, and they seemed to be staying together just fine. So I created those. And then I was on a doily making spree, so I made some paper clips because I spoke with Kerry, and she does a little bit of the planning like I do, but not over the board. So I didn't know if she could really use these, but in any event, she could take the paper clips off and just use them as regular rosettes. And again, these are the same. It's just the pattern paper with the flowers from Wild Orchid Crafts. And there are those. And because I was making so many of them, I actually made four more. And these are just in a box that I cut from my Silhouette. I'm trying to hold it so that there's no, let's see, there's no glare. But you guys can see this is another set, and it's exactly the same, except the little pieces that I used are in the background. You can kind of see they're gold. And I don't want to open up this packaging. It's a little box that I cut from my Silhouette, and if I remember, I will link it below with just some simple seam binding and some flowers. So there are those. So as I was creating, I wanted to make a few things. So one of the first things that I made, actually, let me do this first. So I made this little pillow box. And again, this was from a cut from my Silhouette. And then I used one of my butterfly dies to cut out the piece and just added some acetate on it. And it's just some of the pink-ish, peachy, flat-back pearls. And hold it like that, and it's right side up. Just some seam binding, and then some more flowers. And then, let's go ahead and take this out. So one of the first things that I made was actually this notepad. So with this notepad, I took it apart, and so I uncoiled it, and then I covered the back cover and front cover with some pattern paper, added some roses, and again, all these flowers are actually from Wild Orchid Crafts, added some seam binding and some of the antique looking pearls, and on the back side to hold the seam binding in so that when it's untied, that the seam binding just doesn't get lost, I added this little cut from the actual paper collection, and I'm just going to untie it and I'll retie it later. But it says, a woman can be overdressed, but never over elegant. And that was from Chanel, but Coco Chanel. And see, I left the regular papers just plain, but then I covered the insides of both, the inside and outside. I did want to color the spiral in gold, but it just, it was, anyway, had some issues with the rub and buff that I had. So I created this. And then, excuse me. Excuse me. And then as I was creating, I was like, well, I need to have a pen. And I had a totally different idea for the pen that I originally was going to do. And then I was like, well, I'm going to work with what I have. So I took a pen and I covered it in seam binding. And then I covered it again in lace. This is actually a pressure point pen. So you push it like that. And then I fixed it so if you push the gold part, it retracts. So before this pen was, let me see if I can get another one. I might have a sample if I can get to it quick enough. There it is. So this was the pen that I started with, and I turned it into this pen, and I'm pretty proud of it. So it's just a lot of fun. So there was that pen to go with the notepad. The next thing, I just want to be careful as I'm taking stuff out, was this little pillow box, and this is just full of sequins. So I cut it out and then added acetate to the front and back windows, and then added a ton of sequins from my stash, and added some more seam binding and also flowers from Wild Orchid Crafts. Next is a bunch of words that I created, I cut out and created on my silhouette. So it's just some simple packaging. I use that doily edge punch from Martha Stewart, and then my bow die. And this bow die is from Little Bee Crafts. And there's tons of words in there, like hello, dream, laugh, live, princess, that kind of stuff, and to go along with the collection. And so what I did was I cut them out of white cardstock. I inked it with, what is it, Tattered Rose, and then the words, I cut those out, and then I glittered them, and then I also on those glossy accented them. So I don't know if you guys can see that, but there are those. Making sure that's all that's in that front pocket. This thing is about ready to break, and I want to be careful with it. Okay, so now I'm going to take out these. So this is 4 pinwheels that I created. So I cut them out of the patterned paper. I had some little white lace doilies, and these are from I Am Roses, and then some of the antique pearls, and I just wrapped them in seam binding. This is a little package that I just created using my scoreboard, some acetate, and some cardstock and patterned paper. There is another set. So I made 2 sets of these. One has more of a blue look to them, and then the others are more pink. Next is a bunch of die cuts that I cut out of pattern paper and also white cardstock. So in here, there's some doilies. There's a ton of butterflies. I cut a couple of fans and a gate and just some other stuff. And again, kept it simple with acetate bag. And then the bow on the front and the simple border punch. So kept that pretty simple. These are pieces from the pattern paper that I cut apart. So this was the 12 by 12 collection, and I just cut these little pieces. I inked all the edges in Tattered Rose, and so there's some 4x6s in here, or 3x5s, and 3x4s, and some 2x2s in there. And I just wrapped it in the seam binding and added some flowers. And on the back, because I didn't have a bag exactly the same size, I just used some washi tape. And because this is like a regal elegant collection, I just used some neutral washi with crowns on it. Next is some buttons. And so again, it's just some gold and white buttons, fleur-de-lis and things like that, just to go with the collection. So again, it's that simple packaging that you guys have seen me do before. Let's make sure that everything, yep, everything is out of there. I'm going to go ahead and gently remove the wand. and we'll get to that in a second. Okay, now inside. Okay, so this package right here is a package of bling. So it's got those those antiqued pearls. It's got some of the flat, what are they, the flat, I can't even think of what they're called, in black or in white, and then also gold and silver, and then there's the flourishes also. So I just, again, put it in a plastic bag. Didn't have one exactly the right size, so I just used some washi to make the bag form fitting and added some seam binding and also some flowers to just make it look pretty. Okay. Let's do this one next. So these are some frames that I made, and so these are clay frames, and I actually got them from a friend of mine, Christy, who's Crafty Creations here on YouTube, and I paint, these are, I don't remember what mold that these are from, but she made me some, and I painted them white with gesso, and then I used a, it's a Mod Podge Pearlize Spray, and I just sprayed it over the white, and you guys, I don't know if you guys can see that, hopefully there's not a ton of glare on there, but then I added some tiny little rosebuds, some larger rosebuds, and then just some regular roses in different colors. There's some really pale pink ones, there are white ones, and then again, a bag topper, and just the simple packaging like so. Next are some cards, and there are actually, how many cards are there? Three cards? Yeah, three cards. four cards. There's four cards in here. These are, again, from the paper collection, and these are just little, 3x4 cards that they're just little images from the 12x12 set, and so I cut them out, inked them in the Tattered Rose, added a couple of pearls here and there, and they're different. So there's different cards in here, and I popped them up on some foam tape. I don't want to take them all apart. And then I created envelopes, and I stamped the envelopes using the stamps from the collection just to give it a little extra something. But I tried to make them pretty and elegant, but not too dimensional. And I did actually, I don't know if you guys can see that, but they're actually used some, some Wink-A-Stella on them, but I think it's being overshadowed by the glare of the packaging. So there's four little cards in there for her. And then here is the last piece. Now, these are some banners that I made. And again, these banners are from my silhouette. So I cut out the banners and then the words as well. And I took the words from different things in the collection. And there's, you know, be elegant, let them eat cake, keep calm and adjust your tiara, and then be gorgeous. And let me tell you about this be gorgeous one. This is just between you and I, because you can't tell that I actually messed this one up royally. But when I was doing these, Silhouette, if you're listening, you need to put spell check on things, because somehow in my infinite wisdom, when I was typing out gorgeous, I forgot the second G. So it was spelled wrong, and I didn't notice it until, I don't remember what I was doing, but I was doing something and I was like, oh my gosh, I cannot believe I misspelled that. So it was already assembled and I had to take it apart, and that was so scary. But I think if you really, really look at it, like super duper close, you can kind of tell. But thank goodness for old paper, because that definitely helped hide it. So those are the banners that I made. I'm so, so happy with them. I think they turned out so pretty. And then here is my wand. So I did a really big rosette, and then this is an image from the paper collection. So what I did was I laid down some lace from my stash, and then I fussy cut the lady and the guy, and I fussy cut the top, and then for the bottom of her dress, because I couldn't cut the entire dress out because it's really big. I just used one of my circle dies to cut out the bottom part of this, and so it kind of rounds it off. Then I added just some flowers again from my stash, inked it in the Tattered Rose, added this double seam binding bow. This little sentiment right here is actually a sentiment from the chipboard pieces. And then down at the bottom, I added some pearls to the very bottom. And this is just a gold straw from Michaels. Excuse me, added some more of the pink flat back trim. On the back, I used one of my Cherry Lynn doily dies, and then I added just a piece of this is cut out from the pattern paper, and then I added a couple little of what are they, lace bits? I don't even know what you would call them, from my stash, and then one of the antique pearls right there. And I'm going to tell you guys something. I didn't intend originally on putting the pearl bits on there, and I really, they're okay, they're not my favorite on there, but the reason I did that is as I was putting this together, I don't know what I did, but I kind of tweaked the straw right there, and so I was like, well, how do I reinforce this? And this was my solution, so I added two of them there. Plus, it kind of fits in your hand really nicely when you hold it like that. So that is, oh, geez, let's just throw that anywhere. So that is the wand that I created. And then this is just a look at the pocket itself. Oh, so I also actually created a charm. Now, I am not a big fan of charms, but I did create this charm. So I used a lot of... that's the word I'm looking for. I used a lot of pearls and some other gems. There's a key. This little locket piece, it actually opens up and you can put pictures in there. This is a little piece from Butterbeak Scraps, and it's one of her cameo pieces. And I just hung a couple of pearls off the bottom of it. Little crown charm. And then this is a giant piece I had in my stash, and I got it in the clearance section because it was missing the center dangle, and so I just took one of my Tim Holtz pearls and strung it from the center. Now, I did use all different colors of metals, and I'm not really, I don't know, I'm okay with that. I am definitely not a person who is afraid to mix different metals, but I just think it turned out so pretty, and it just hangs on the front. I used one of the Tim Holtz, I always call them door knockers, but I can't remember the word for them, but I just used one of those, and I just punched the hole, and I hung it there so it's there and it can come off easily. So I'm going to go ahead and take that back off so I can show you guys my pocket. So I created my pocket, and I have actually two pockets here. Okay, there's two pockets. There's also another pocket. So technically there's three. So use some of the pattern paper. And again, you can see the man and the woman on the front. When I had originally constructed this, this pocket was closed. And then I decided, hey, I want an open pocket. So then I had to do some surgery. And that was a task in of itself. So to keep how it opens, to keep that strong, I added this butterfly. And then there's another flower behind it. It's very similar to this one right here. I added some flat back trim and also just some lace from my stash. But I tried to kind of let the paper speak for itself. If you look on each of the edges, there is the flat back pearl trim. And yeah. I need to get a little bit better at making sure that... like my hot glue when I'm doing the the flat back pearl, I have the hardest time. On the back of this is a envelope or a policy envelope, and this has the swap information in it, but you can't take it out unless it's empty because it's too bulgy otherwise. So you can see it's kind of been curved because that's how it is. So on on the back, I put some patterned paper. I used an EK Success border punch, and then I fussy cut this image. And then on the other side, it has the swap information. It's a graphic 45 loaded envelope. It was hosted by Deb Crafty Texas Woman. And then my YouTube information, and then February 2017, and then my name. So that is the end of the envelope. So that just slips back in there, wraps it around just a couple of times. Put this back on. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll just kind of pile this stuff back. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope Kerry, my partner, likes it. If you guys have any questions or anything like that, let me know, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.